people, and welcome to M Street TV, where I share insights to help you discover, capture, and reveal your unique brand story. I am your host, Marisha, and today I wanted to reveal some strategies to help you begin crafting your sticky story. A message that's memorable and will not only connect you with your target audience more effectively, but it will keep you at the top of mind when they need your product or service. All because, that's right, they remembered your sticky story. Today, I want to illustrate three key things you want to keep in mind when you are preparing to create and tell the story of your business. Now, this story can be for a new orientation meeting, the launch of a product or service that will be promoted on your website or social media, or the story may be for a keynote speech or a workshop that will hopefully reel in more new customers and business partners. And now for the three sticky storytelling tips to help you begin creating stronger relationships with your current and potential customers. Tip number one. The time. That's right. Explore your memory bank to find stories that made you feel the way you want to make your ideal customers feel. Think back to how and why this story drew you in and ultimately led to you doing business with that particular brand. Was there anything that the storyteller or the brand could have done differently to make it more appealing or real to you and your specific experiences? There is so much to learn from your very own encounters with stories you've experienced. Try identifying the goals of the stories and what was most appealing about them. Think of several different purchases that you've made from brands in different industries. Do not skip this part of the process. Your discoveries will surely enlighten you and give you profound ideas to run with. Tip number two, set a clear vision. Always remember the five W's, which I will break down for you right now, starting with who. When writing your story, are you intending to communicate with your ideal client, an employee, a vendor, a sponsor, or a potential business partner? All of whom need to be connected to your story. Next is what. Please be advised, this is not just about your benefits or features of your product or service. This is about relationship building. Painting the picture of who you are, what you do, and how it is beneficial to others. The what is about being able to identify the current issues as well as the changes in your ideal client's behavior or circumstances. Storytelling is about knowing what emotions are triggered without you and how you can tap into those emotions with your story. Where? Give context. There should always be versatility in what you have to offer. For example, you're a flower shop owner. And you want to be creative and humorous, so you display at the entrance of your shop three different size bouquets with a simple sign above them that reads, "Forgot her special day? How mad is she?" In the home and garden section of your shop, you can have a summer promotion advertised that reads, "DIY gardening, bringing families together again." The same scenario at the same flower shop, the owner could have, right at the checkout, large potted plants with a sign that reads, "Because your office needs a little life." In each of the examples, there was a short story that provided context as to where would be the best place and time to consider using those advertised items. The setting and the emotions of the ideal customer were highlighted more than anything else, making the story about the product more real. When? We will talk about editorial calendars in a greater detail in another episode, but this is important to know when to share your stories, and some things that will help with framing them are current events. What's going on already in the world or in your local community or in your industry that can help you convey your message more clearly? Are there any certain traditions, holidays? Is it a specific season? Also think about when to give personal testimonials, data, and when to fluctuate your tone and really emphasize certain words or phrases. Why? Every story has its purpose. There is a conclusion, a point that every storyteller is trying to make. What's yours? Is it a new potential customer that you're trying to build a relationship with? Is it a loyal client that you're trying to keep engaged with your company's products or service? Are you implementing a new corporate social responsibility program and you want to build support around a specific cause? And how? This is the bonus. How are you going to tell your story? There's a number of communication mediums out there, be it Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, your website, forums, blogs, etc. But there is evidence that using visuals and not just written data or content, it's way more effective in terms of maintaining its sticky factor. So how are you going to communicate the story you wish to tell? Now that was tip number two, having a clear vision, specifically focusing on your five W's. And lastly, tip number three, rally your starting five. Remember when you were a kid at recess and there was a four square game or a kickball game and it required two team captains to pick from the handful of kids remaining? There were certain things that each captain had in mind when recruiting their teammates, which is exactly what this point is all about. It's simply just a metaphor for picking your all-star teammates that will be there to support you in the process of discovering, capturing, and revealing your unique brand story. You may be a small business owner, the CMO of a large firm, or even if you're a startup, there are going to be human resources that you need to help you effectively tell your story. Now, first things first, they must have the same passion for what you're doing. People are more productive when they feel passionate about something, and you want them to have the same drive and work ethic that is committed to the cause. Next, your top five should be diverse in terms of their skill sets. Because you're going to need to accomplish different tasks, having teammates with expertise in and a passion for those tasks or required skills will be vital. Lastly, consider the combined networks of your teammates, as this will be the most important thing in obtaining the reach you need to get your story heard by as many of the right or target customers as possible. And there you have it, folks. Three tips you can use to discover, capture, and reveal your unique brand story. If you found that helpful, I have additional links to my blog for you in the description of this video. Click below to be led to more juicy insight on using storytelling as a surefire way to connect more authentically to your desired clients. Be sure to like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel as well. I'm Marisha, and I'm here to engage, educate, and empower people, businesses, and communities that are making a positive impact on the world by helping them to discover, capture, and reveal their unique brand story. My philosophy is simple. We are all connected, and I believe that if we don't show up and share our purpose with the world, we could potentially be preventing someone else from fulfilling theirs. Make sure you show up and share your story with the world today. That's all for M Street TV today, folks. Thanks for watching.